to TBMS lecture. Yesterday, in my previous lecture, I have finished Unit 4. And today, I'll be taking up lab number 3, lab term of number 3 for you. Okay, so let's start. So lab term of number 3 is concerned with movie database. So we have seen the prior to term work with the other databases. So we have to see another database. I'll show you the problem definition. We will try and analyze it and derive meaning out of it. So this is the problem definition for you. It reads, this is a movie database. Data requirements of a movie industry are captured. Each movie is identified by its movie ID. So each movie. So I can, when I read that term, the sentence here, which says each movie is identified by movie ID, let me just highlight it for you. So I'm reading here. Okay. So I'm saying each movie is identified by its movie ID, which is created by using first letter of the title and release year. Okay. So that's a hint that has been given as to how, what kind of entry has to be made for movie ID. Okay. So what meaning do we derive out of this sentence is each movie is identified by its movie ID. That means movie is what? Movie is an entity, and movie ID is its attribute. Okay, so movie in the database is a relation which is having the attribute or the column. One of the columns is movie ID, which is nothing but the attribute of that particular entity. Now, what has been told about it? When you enter, when you have made the database and you are going to insert the data in it, then at that time you have to remember that movie ID will be created with the first letter of the movie title and the year that it is released. For example, if the movie title is Dabang, D is the name, D is the first letter, so D, and supposingly it was released in 2009, then it would be this. Okay, so this kind of entry is expected. So that's something for us to remember when we are entering the data into the database. However, we have to keep analyzing and keep things in mind. And let's go ahead. It says that, and it also has movie title, category, production house name, and release year. So how many attributes are there? You can see there is movie ID, then there is movie title, then there is category, there is production house name, and release year. These are the various attributes for which entity? For movie entity. Okay. Now, let's go ahead and it reads, so I'll just put my pointer there. I'm reading here. So it says actors and directors are identified by their IDs. So what are actors and directors? They are identified by their ID, that means that's some characteristic that they have. When characteristics are being defined for something, that definitely is an entity. Entity has its own attributes or properties or characteristics, right? So actors and directors are definitely the other two entities that we have identified as present. And they also have name, age, gender as other attributes. So which are the other attributes of these two entities? So which all entities have we identified till now? First entity that we identified is movie entity, obviously. Okay. Then we identified there is an actor entity. Then there is director. Okay. So now look at this. And the various attributes have been told for each one of them. Then goes production house is identified by its name itself, and it has the name of the producer and age. So there is another entity which is production house. Okay. Production house. Fine. So it has the attributes like name of the producer, age, and the name of the production house itself. Okay. Then actor can act in several movies, and the movie can have several actors acting in it. Okay. So let's now try. So we have identified four basic entities: movie entity, actor entity, director entity, and production house entity. Okay, having identified the entities and their properties that have been listed there, let's try and make the ER diagram, and we'll read the sentences which are talking about the various relationships between the different tables. One by one, we'll read out the sentences and try and make up the meaning out of it. So these are the queries. I'll directly take you to the ER diagram. Now, hope this is visible to you. So you can see here that this is the ER diagram. Now, in this ER diagram, if you can just see that we have put up, so let's at least analyze which are the different entities. Forget about the relationships between them, but let's figure out the entities. So for the movie, the entity, can you see there is movie ID, there is title, there is this category and year. Okay. Then for actor, you have actor ID, which I have defined as AID, name, gender and age. Okay. Director, you have director ID, name, age, gender. And for production house, which I have just written as, I have given the table name as production instead of the entire thing, production house. And what are the entities there? Name, the producer name, P name, and age. So these are the various entities of this entire database. So let's analyze them one by one, and I don't think I'll be able to. I'll definitely show you this diagram one more time after we have generated it on the board. So what I'll do is, for the convenience of understanding, because the problem definition is here itself, so what I'll do is draw it on the board itself. So let's do it part by part. So I'll draw the various entities here. So there is movie entity, and what are the attributes? There is movie ID, and then there is title, then there is category. So I'll just write it as CAT. Hope this is visible to you. Okay. And okay. So this is here. Then I'll draw another entity here, which is entity. Placing the entity here and there will absolutely not matter to us. You can place this particular entity down or left side or right side, up, down, anywhere. The relationship has to be properly defined. That is what the placement, where do you place it, is absolutely immaterial. There is actor ID for the actor, then there is there is director entity, which I will write it as, name it as director. So this is the another table that I have in my database. So there is director. Then there are the various attributes like director ID. So I'll write it as DID. Okay. Then I have name. So I'll write it as name. Then there is age. Okay. And gender. So maybe I'll write it here. Okay. So there is gender. So this is another attribute. Another entity. So I'll write another entity, one more entity which is left out, which is production house. Though I have just given the name as production, if you desire, you might give the name as production_house. Definitely, when you're naming any particular relation, you have to bear it in mind that you cannot have spaces. So production_house should be more than enough. But however, I have given it as production, And then what all do we have for it is, it has production house, you can read it there, production house at its own name. So I'll write it as name here. Then there is producer name, which I will say it as P name. So please understand the difference between a name and P name. P name is the producer name, according to me. Okay, according to me, in my ER diagram, P name indicates the producer name and name indicates the name of the production house. Okay, so thereafter there is one more H. So can you just tally it from there whether I have put all the entities? Yes, for movie database, what they told is yes, one more thing they have told in movie database, if you can just highlight with the laser here, I just put my cursor there, yes, pointer here. So you can see this is what I have not put. What does it say? It has movie ID, it has movie title, so movie ID is there, movie title is there, okay, category is there, so category is also there, and then production house name. Now, why have I not put that is because when you will actually generate this, what will happen is these turn out to be in a relation wherein its primary key, that is the production house name, will automatically become a foreign key here. So anyhow, I'll be inserting it. So in the ER diagram, I am not putting it because I understand that when this primary key becomes a foreign key here, it automatically gets inserted as a foreign key. Okay, so in the schema anyhow it is going to be added, so I'm not putting it now. So either this way or that way production name will get inserted. So my understanding is I will not put it now, and in the schema automatically it will be added. So that's what is remaining. Otherwise you can see that the actor directors, so you have director, you have actor, they have the IDs. So director has D ID, actor has A ID, and name, gender age, name, gender A is there. Okay, and for production house, it has its own name, and then it has the producer name and age. So these are couple of attributes for the various entities which have been defined here. So let's go sequentially, analyzing every sentence thereafter, which will define the relationship between the different tables here that which are put up. Okay, so it reads, I'm reading here, the sentence, okay, actor can act in several movies. So movies, okay, actor is there, movie is here. Actors can act in several movies, and movie can have several actors acting in it. So what has happened is, you can see that actors can act in several movies. So one is to n relationship. And vice versa is also true. That means in a movie, in a single movie, lot of actors can be there. So it is one this side and n this side. So what has happened? It is many to many relationship. Okay? So I will define this relationship, and I will write it as has, and I'll join it here. Okay? And it is total total hope you have understood why I am saying M is to N relationship, because the problem definition reads so. Okay? Then director, I'm reading it here, director can direct several movies. Director can direct. So where is my director? Director is here. Can direct several movies. And a movie can be directed by more than one director. So this movie to director, again, like this relationship is M is to N relationship. Okay, so I will just define the relationship here. Maybe I will write the relationship as directed by. Okay, so this is my relationship, and definitely it is total participation. So it is M is to N relationship. Thereafter, each movie is produced by exactly one production house, and production house can produce more than one movie. That means we exactly production house. Okay, and production house this many movies. So it is N this side and 1 this side. 1 is to N relationship is there between the production house and the movie. So I'll just build the relationship between them. So what name should I give? I'll say produced by. So this is the relationship that I have, and total participation from both these sides. Okay, so it is M this side and 1 this side. Okay, so this is what is my ER diagram. Yes, I had to underline the primary keys, unless and until I have, it is not complete. Okay, unless and until I underline the primary keys or identify my primary keys, it is not complete. So let me underline. So you have the MID, that is movie ID, being the primary key here, because you can see the other attributes which are there are not capable of becoming primary key or the key attributes. AID, that is actor ID, is the primary key here. Direction ID is key here. And name, that is production house name, is the primary key here. So, it's a neat. So this is what is the ER diagram. So this is what I actually showed you. This is what I generated. Okay. So this is what is generated. So you can see this is what I have put on the paper. Hope this is clear. If this is not clear, you can look at the screen. I mean the board here. And this is what we done. So you should, the analysis of it has to be proper. Once the analysis is done, then you can go ahead and make the database properly. Now let's go ahead, and queries will be seeing it later. Let's see the schema diagram now. Okay. Now in the schema diagram, now ER diagram is here and schema you have to make. So it should be easy for you to tally from here to there now. Now which all tables are there? Now you know there are 4 basic tables at least. There is a movie table with these all attributes or these all columns. Then there is actor entity or a actor table with these all columns or these all attributes. Then there is director with these all attributes. And there is production with these all attributes. Then which other tables will I need? Definitely, we have seen from the 7-step algorithm. Go through the 7-step algorithm and only then you will be, every time read it step by step. Now you know M is to N relationship when you have, then the relationship table has to be there, which will comprise of the primary ID of the both the tables. So director ID and MID should be a part here. Okay. So you will have your MID and director ID both comprising of in this particular table, because it is a M is to N relationship. Similarly, there is M is to N relationship in here, and here I will have to have the primary keys of both the tables, that is MID and AID. Okay, so this has to be there. Other than that, because this is N is to N relationship, whichever is the one side, its primary key has to become the foreign key in this particular table. So these are some understandings while converting the ER diagram into the schema. So let's do it. So I have put the movie entity on top. So you can see here. So you can see here. Movie ID or movie entity on top. So which all attributes are there? There is movie ID, title, category here. Okay. Now, because this movie ID has a 1:N relationship between movie and production, its primary key, that is name, has to be put as foreign key here. That is what, it is not P name. Sorry, I'll just redo it. I mean, mistakenly. It is not P name. Why? Because P name is production, producer name. And what I want is, so can I use a pen here to just rectify the mistake? I'll just scratch this. It is not. So does it look like I've scratched? Okay. So it is only name. Name is what? What is name here? Name here is the production house name, which has to become the foreign period. Okay. So it is not the producer name. Producer name attribute is also there, but that is not what you have to put. Okay, you have to put this. So this is what has to be put. So I've just scratched it. Hope you will understand. Then there is actor. Okay, so that connectivity has to be built. You can build it later because I have still not written the production production entity and its attributes. So put all the tables, and these are the two tables. This is the table which is related. These are the regular four tables, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, what is this actor movie? Actor movie is this attribute, entity, which is the relationship entity, which has the attributes primary key of this table and primary key of this table, which I told you as movie ID and the actor ID. Okay, and this that is directed. Okay, directed is this particular attribute, it is entity. Directed is the entity between movie and director, which is the relationship entity and which has the attributes of both the primary keys of both the tables. So MID from here and director ID from here has to be put. So that is what has, and then I have just built the lines between them. Okay, hope you know and understand it well how to draw the connectivity between them. Foreign key, you are just supposed to draw without an arrow mark. So you can see, now how do I highlight here? Now look at this, production house, this name had to be put in the movie database, right? So name is following this line and it goes till the movie attribute. Okay, so there is no arrow mark when it comes to foreign key, but when it comes to primary key, it has arrow mark. So wherever it is a primary key, you will show an arrow mark. So it is an arrow mark here, but when you connect it to the movie database name, it is no arrow mark, indicating that that's the foreign key and this is the primary key. Now what happens about this relationship table? It is an in-between table which will have a connection. So from whichever table it is coming, you have to show from which table it is coming. So it is in between table between movie and director. This is an in between table between movie and actor. So this is what is the schema which is generated. Definitely it has made things clear for us. What are the things clear for us is that which are the primary keys, which are the foreign keys, these all things have been made clear. Do you want me to draw again it on the board? Is this clear, or do you want me to draw it on the board one more time? Okay, so let me try and make it on the board. I don't know how many of you are able to understand the lines which are connecting the different tables, because unless and until you understand the connectivity between the different tables, there is no point, because you will not be able to build the database. Okay, let me just Why? for you to understand, I'll just take you back to this ER diagram, and you can just try tally it here what attributes I'm writing and what entities I'm drawing here, what tables and their attributes. You can just tally it from here. I'll just quickly draw the tables. There is production, name of the production house, the producer name, and hope this is visible to you all. Give me a second and then I'll move for you to view the all the tables. I'll just write them, finish writing them, and then I'll give you a view of what is actually happening here. Then is actor movies. This is the relationship table. You can name it anyhow. These are the identifiers for the tables. So you can just name them anyhow. AID, that is actor ID, and movie ID are the only two attributes here. So I'll erase this part. And then there is one more, which I'll draw it first, preferably here only, and that is directed table. And it has which all attributes? It has movie ID and director ID. Okay, so these are the different tables that we have. Now, I'll just underline the various primary keys. So this is the primary key, this is the primary key, this is the primary key here, and this is the primary key here. So you can see that production house name had to be inserted here because it is one to n relationship. So that is why it's primary key. So whenever I am joining the primary key, I have to put an arrow mark. Okay, whenever I'm pointing to the primary key and take the line to join to get another name to it. There is no compulsion that the name here should match it there, but then I am doing it for the convenience of understanding. Okay, so I've given it the same name. Thereafter, the actor. Okay, now comes the relationship between the different tables. That is, you have movie and actor, you have actor movies table. So what is happening is the primary key from here is a foreign key here, so it is an arrow mark here and there is no arrow mark here. Do we understand that? Why? Because this is the relationship table. See here, this is actor movie table, which is the relationship between actor and movies. Between actor and movies, that has what I have written is this table. Okay, so what will it comprise of? As I had told you, primary key of that table and primary key of this table. So what is the primary key of movies table? MID. What is the primary key of actor table? It is AID. So I'll just merely put that. So look here, in this table, AID and MID are put. So I'm just, where is it primary key? It is primary key in actor key and it is foreign key here. Now similarly, MID is a primary key and I'll take it down to indicate that it is the foreign key here. So without arrow mark. So wherever it is arrow mark, see here, arrow mark, that is the primary key, and wherever it is not arrow mark, it is the foreign key. Similarly, director and the movie, you have the directed table. So what is happening is DID, which is a primary key here in director, is a foreign key here in this relationship. So you can see this relationship directed by. So it has the primary key of movie table and it has the primary key of director table. So both have been put, movie ID and director ID. Okay, I just have to join and show it. Okay, so movie ID, I'll just make an arrow mark there indicating that it is a primary key, and it is joined simply like this to indicate that it is a foreign key. Similarly, DID is a directed table, is from the director table, and where is the directory table? It's here. Okay, so I'll just take it here to indicate, and I'll put an arrow mark saying that it is primary key here. Okay, so this is what is my schema. So very simply, it has got converted into tables now. Okay, now these tables have their primary keys. You can see the primary keys here. So these all entities have these all primary keys. Now these have foreign keys here, and this is also a foreign key. So you have to create the database using that. Okay, one more thing I wanted to tell you here is, in the understanding of DBMS, you have to stop at this juncture wherein you are now ready with the schema, and then tally your knowledge or get back to your knowledge of what you acquired during the normalization theory that we studied about. I mean, the theory that we studied. There we have acquired some knowledge. We have understood that when we have designed a particular database in this fashion, then we have to take a pause and normalize our database using the various normal forms. Now, how many normal forms we have been using? There were 5 normal forms. Apart from that, BCNF, that is Boycott normal form, was also there. And I have also told you, if not all normal forms, at least 2 to 3 normal forms, or till Boycott normal form, at least you should try and put the knowledge that you have acquired and normalize the table. Okay, so this is what is the understanding that goes. So this is the juncture where we started with our problem definition, we generated the ER diagram, then we have generated the schema, and now we want to find out whether our tables are already normalized or they need any kind of normalization. This is what you have to do in your projects also. You'll be taking up when you go higher to your higher semesters in your curriculum. Then you will have to do your mini projects, and then you have to do in your final semester the full-fledged one final project. In that, you have to actually do this. Yes, definitely, it is much easier here. Not many discrepancies might come. Not much normalization will be required. Why? Because the tables are very less. The number of tables is very less. So not much activity you will have to do in terms of normalization. But then yes, when it comes to huge databases, normalization is a very important aspect of project building. So then you have to really take a pause and do the normalization process properly. Otherwise, your database will be generated, and then it will start giving you all kinds of problems because the tables are not normalized. Okay, so I'll just take a pause, and I'll take you to my previous normalization PPT and remind you of all the various normalization processes, and get back here, and we'll try and apply our knowledge here to see whether our database here is normalized or it needs anything. So this is our normal forms. So these were all our normal forms. To remind you, there were these all normal forms: 1NF, 2NF, 3NF, BCNF, 4NF, and 5NF. First normal form, second normal form, third normal form, BCNF, that is Boycott normal form, fourth and fifth normal form. Okay. So these were the different normal forms. And to remind you, the first normal form is about the atomic values. That means you should have, you should not have, schema JNB being sure. So, or you should not have something like multi-valued attributes. So atomic values have to be stored. So this is what is the first normal form. Then the second normal form talks about the partial dependency. Partial dependency is if you have decided some key attribute, then all the other attributes, the non-key attributes, have to completely depend on the key attribute. So assumingly in the example I had told you, if A and B together are making up to the key attribute or both together are acting as key attribute, then you should make sure that all the other attributes are completely dependent. For example, C is only dependent on B, that is partial dependency is not allowed. In that case, what you should do, you should try and put this in the other table. So option I had given you. So in that case, you want to solve, what can be done? A, B, D had to be can be retained in the same table, and B and C can be separately put, wherein B can become the key attribute and C is dependent on it. So that's possible. So why it has to be done, I had given you example in the form of table, you know. So this was about second normal form. So first normal form is atomic value, second normal form is about the partial dependency. Then the third normal form is transitive dependency. So what is transitive? On AB, the key attribute C is dependent, on C, D is dependent. That means what? B is dependent on a non-key attribute. That is very wrong. Why it cannot be allowed is because C can anytime take a null value. In that case, how do you identify D? So these problems I had already discussed. This I have shifted between the PPTs. It's for only reminder. So all, I just sincerely hope you have gone through all my previous lectures. In case you have not gone through that particular lecture wherein I have talked about the normalization processes or normal forms, then you will really have to go back there and try and understand, because what I'm saying is just a zest of what I have already talked in 1 hour duration lecture. Okay, so this is what was transitive. So third one, so we have talked about first, second, third, atomic values, then there is the partial dependency, then there is transitive dependency, and Boycott normal form. In Boycott normal form, multi-value dependency should not be allowed, or in that case, non-prime attribute cannot depend on a prime attribute. This has to be avoided. Okay, so you have seen here, can you see, B is getting dependent on C. Okay, so B is a key attribute and it is getting dependent on some non-key attribute, that is not allowed. So that has to be avoided. So this was about the various normal forms. So I'll just summarize it for you. Try and remember at least the four of them, initial four of them. First is the first normal form, second normal form, third normal form, and the Boycott normal form. So first normal form talked about the atomic values, second normal form talked about the partial dependency, third normal form talks about the transitive dependency, and Boycott normal form talks about a non-prime key attribute depending on a prime attribute. In that case, you should try and avoid it. So that is what has to be avoided. So what we will do is, we'll again get back to our original PPT here, what we were supposed to do. So let's start the slideshow. So this is the juncture where we had stopped. Okay, so this is where we had stopped, and I wanted you to, okay, this is our ER diagram, let it be on display. So this is what is my schema, this is what is my ER diagram, and then we have to try and analyze in terms of the normalizations that we have, normal forms that we have learned. So first normal form, atomic values, okay. So please see each of the tables to figure out whether each one of the table has atomic values. All the attributes have atomic values. MID, title, no problem, category, year, name. So you can go through each one of them to figure out whether they have the atomic values. Atomic values are those values which cannot be divided any further. Okay, so those are atomic values. So you can see. So this is what is the various attributes. So no problem in terms of first normal form. So we can conclude that the database is in first normal form. What about the second normal form? Second normal form talks about the partial dependency. That means look at each one of the tables to figure out whether it is partially dependent on the key attribute. Partially dependent as in, if there are two attributes making up to a key attribute, then the non-key attribute is only dependent on one of it. That concept is known as partial dependency. So you will have to try and figure out for each one of the entity whether there is any partial dependency between the attributes. So let's go with the first entity, that is movie table. So MID is our primary key. Now can you try and figure out whether title is dependent on movie ID? Yes, there is no partial dependency. Whether category is dependent on movie ID? Yes. Okay, year? Yes. And name? Yes. So there is no problem. So likewise, you can see for actor, is name dependent on actor ID? Yes, name of the actor will depend on actor ID. So depending on actor ID, I'll give the name. How your role number is relevant or related to the name that you have, or your name is related to the role number that you have. Similarly, gender, age, so there is no partial dependency here. So this is, so you can go in for each one of them and try and figure out on these lines whether there is any partial dependency. So you can see none of the tables have any two attributes making up to the key attribute. So there is no problem. What about the third normal form? Now third normal form talks about transitive dependency. Okay, on the key attribute, some attribute is dependent. On that non-prime attribute, some other attribute is dependent. Is that the case? Is it something like that? Can you just try and figure out if there is any transitive? Look at the first table. MID is primary key. Whether there is any transitive dependency, that on a non-prime attribute, some non-prime attribute is dependent. No, because all of them are dependent on the prime attribute. You have to see whether MID is capable of recognizing each one of them, extracting the data from the table, from each of the columns. You have to understand that. Okay, so that is what is partial, the transitive dependency. So can you just see whether there is any transitive dependency? If no, then we have the third normal form. So this database is in third normal form also. What about the Boycott normal form? Boycott normal form talks about a prime attribute dependent on a non-prime attribute. Is it the case in any of the tables? Can you see in movie table, is this dependent on any non-key attribute? Is movie ID dependent on any of these? No. Is AID dependent on any non-key attribute? Absolutely no. And so also all the other tables. So this concludes that at least our database is in the basic normal form till the Boycott normal form. So at least so much so we have concluded. So every time the process or the step says of building a database, you have to go through the problem definition, understand it, make the ER diagram, make the schema, then yes, definitely making the schema using those 7 steps. Then after the schema is ready, you have to analyze whether they are all normalized, okay, whether all the tables are normalized. And then you have to keep in front of your eyes all those normal forms and the knowledge that you have acquired in the lecture of normal forms, and then try and figure out whether your database is in the normal form. I mean, all those normal forms rules are applied to it. Once we have done that, we are all set to convert it into the database. Okay, so please analyze the various normal forms. I'll just take a tiny break and get back to you. Till then, you can try and think of the various normal forms that I reminded you of, and look at the schema, look at the ER diagram, and try and figure out whether they are actually in those normal forms. And I'll get back. वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स. लेट्स रिज्यूम. सो दिस वॉज अबाउट हाउ एट वॉट जंक्चर वी हैव टू थिंक अबाउट अप्लाइंग द नॉर्मल फॉर्म. सो वी ट्राई टू अप्लाई अ लिटिल ऑफ आवर नॉलेज ऑफ नॉर्मल फॉर्म्स टू आवर डेटाबेस विच इज क्रिएटेड हियर. सो लेट्स गो अहेड एंड टॉक अबाउट द क्रिएट कमांड. सो लेट मी जस्ट रिमाइंड यू ऑफ द वेरियस. ओके, so we are doing the create command. So this is the table. Okay, we have no problem. The schema is here, so you should be able to relate. Okay, schema is here. I'll keep it on, not erase it. And let's talk about how do we create the different tables. So create command, you all are aware of, hope you have brushed it up well. So please make the best use of this time that you have got. And I have already introduced you people to the various facilities which are available online. So you need not crib about, not having the laptop with you, or do not have the software installed on it. Since this go online, there are a lot of softwares available. We have done our lab sessions on them. And I hope you are sincerely making efforts to learn DBMS, because whatever best from my side in this lockdown period, I'm doing it. But then practice is definitely up to you. So please practice well, because DBMS is one of the key subjects which will be there in your interviews, and future knowledge also is very much required for doing your projects, whether mini project or the main project in the future. So I sincerely hope you are doing enough practice. Now look at this, the first table that has to be created. Now when you look at the schema, it is very well understood that this is the primary key, these are the different attributes, and this is the foreign key. So I have to make arrangement for it. So create table moving. Do you want me to put the laser on? So let's see. Okay, I am here. Create table movie, and which all attributes are there? Movie ID, because remember about movie ID, it talked about the initial initials of the title and the year that it is. So it is varchar combination of, so varchar might do the trick for you. So I have given MID, that is movie ID, the data type varchar 10, then it is a primary key. So I have written the primary key there itself, or you might write it, come down and write it separately is also fine. So primary key. Thereafter the title, there is another attribute which you can see is title. So title, which again is going to be string type. So varchar 20, you can increase or decrease the size according to your understanding. That is no problem. Then the third attribute is category, wherein the data type has come down. Okay, so it is varchar 20. Varchar has been repeated twice mistakenly, but then it is just varchar 20. So just strike it out for you. It has just been repeated twice. It is not so. Okay, I hope you understand that I've tried to strike it out. Not very neatly though, but then yes, it is striked out. So category has varchar 20. Then there is year, which I have given it as number 4. So year will have only 4 digits, I have given 4 besides. Then name as varchar 20. Then I have this as the foreign key. And I have already told you the syntax, how to define a foreign key. When there is, this is the foreign key, you simply write foreign key in the bracket name, and you will write references which particular table. So where is this name? It is in production house. Okay, so here it is primary key. So it is references, it says production in the bracket name. So this is what is your create table. Now create table for the actor. Now create table for the actor, it simply goes, this is the primary key, no foreign key here, so it is very simple. You just have to put this as primary key and give data for each one of them. So I'll just read it out. Hope it is simple for you. So create table actor. Create table actor. I'll just put the pointer for you here. One second. I'll just So here you go with the second table, that is the table actor. So AID, name, gender and age have been given the data types, and AID has been made the primary key. Now come to the director table. Now in director table, you have absolutely no problem, because wherever there is foreign key, you really, in these two tables there is foreign key, so you have to write the foreign key, the syntax properly. Otherwise, I don't think there is any problem when you're writing the primary key. You just have to, in front of the column, you just write it as primary key, so it surely becomes the primary. So here, director table, so you can see director table, all of them have been given the data type, and in front of DID, that is director ID, primary key keyword has been written, indicating that it is the primary key. Okay, so this is the third table. Now let's go to the next table, that is production house. So here, production house. So in production house also, this is the primary key, that is name of the production house is the primary key. Rest all are the only the attributes. So you can see in front of name it is written as primary key. So there is absolutely no problem. Now here, in this, what you can see is AID, you have to give it a data type. MID, you have to give it a data type. But also, you have to make them both as foreign key. So you could just, make them as foreign key. So they both have been. And you have to tell where are the primary key, where are they referencing. So you have to actually go back to their original table to references, which particular table, which column name. Because it is quite possible that AID is named as AID here and something actor ID here. You know, the names might be different. So that is why you have to give it in brackets. Foreign key here is named as DID, and references, director table, and there what is the name is DID. Now, fortunately for us, in our example, we have kept the name same, but it is possible for you to give them different names. So the provision is made that both the sides in the bracket, you indicate their names. Foreign key, what is the name, and primary key, what is the name. Okay, so these two tables are also made. So this is what we have created, the tables. Then you have to just populate this table and go ahead with the query. I'll just see how much time I'm left out with. Not much time do I have, but let's try and take up the first query. Okay, so look at this. So the first query says, list the movie names directed by more than one director. So I have to fetch the movie names. Where is the movie name? Movie name is indicated in the title. Okay, title column. Now I am just fetching that. Now I have given the alias. So movie, I have given the alias as M. Director table, I have given them alias as D. And I have to, so what do I have by, what is being said is list the movie names directed by more than one director. So in the ER diagram, if I had to show you in the ER diagram, so see here, between the movie and the director, there is directed the table. So I'm talking about movie ID being displayed, which is directed by the director. So I am talking about director and movie, so definitely I am talking about three tables. Why? Because movie and director are not directly related, they are related through the directed table. So I have to make use of three tables. So this is what is being done here. Okay, so you can see movie has been given the alias M and directed has been given the alias D. Where, what has to be valid? the movie ID here and the movie ID in the directed table, both are the same. So M dot MID, and I have given an alias for directed as D, so D dot MID are same. And what do? I have to count, list the movie names directed by more than one director. So I have to count the number of directions. So the only when they directed it, the movie titles are here. So what am I doing? I'm just grouping them in the form of M title and then counting that and finding out whether it is more than one. So I will get whether if it is more than one, I will be grouping them and I'll be counting whether there it is more than one. So this is what is our first query. I'm not left out with any more time, so I'll just pause, try out the other queries and get back to me if you do not understand, or maybe in my next lecture I'll just try and cover the other queries for you. Hope you have understood so much. Try and execute it in online applications, or if you have Oracle installed, execute on it or MySQL, and please make the concepts clear for you. Hope to see you soon. Take care of yourself. Bye-bye.